this video, you'll learn the proper procedures for fixing a driver file is missing or device not detected error in PowerAlert for an SNMP web card. The most common reason for these error messages to appear is that the driver file, also known as the data file, did not load properly during a recent firmware upgrade. The solution is to reload the data file, which is one of the SNMP web card's firmware files. Before continuing with this video, please confirm that your SNMP web card is running the latest firmware version. You can do this by logging into the card's IP address and checking the information in the Help section of PowerAlert. If your web card is not running the latest firmware version, please refer to the video titled How to Upgrade Firmware on an SNMP Web Card. If your web card is running the latest firmware version, here are the steps for reloading the data file. First, go to TripLite's website at www.triplite.com. On the homepage, type SNMP web card into the search bar at the top. Click Enter, then select the product page for the SNMP web card. On the right side of the product page, underneath the product description, click Firmware. This will open up a smaller window with a button that will allow you to download the firmware files. Enter your email address into this field at the top. Click Download Firmware, and save the zipped folder of files to your desktop. The next step is to go to your desktop and extract the files from the zipped folder. Right-click on the zipped folder and select Extract Here. This will create an unzipped folder just below the zipped folder. Now open the unzipped folder, go into the Firmware folder, and then into the version 12.06.0065 folder. The file you're going to need is in this folder, and it's called PowerAlert.dat. Copy that file to your desktop. The next step is to open up a command prompt and initiate an FTP session with the SNMP web card from your desktop directory. So go into your computer's start menu and type CMD into the search field. In the window that pops up, you're going to change the path to your desktop, which is where that PowerAlert.dat file is located. Type CD, add a space, type desktop, and hit Enter. To connect to the FTP, type the letters FTP, add a space, then type in the IP address of the SNMP web card. Then log in with your username and password. Now it's time to enable the transfer of the data file, the file called PowerAlert.dat. Type BIN for binary file transfer and press Enter. Type PUT, add a space, then type PWRALERT.dat, that's the name of the file, and press Enter. When the transfer is complete, you'll get a message that says Transfer Complete. Type BY, press Enter, and wait 15 to 20 minutes for the card to reboot. After you've given the card enough time to reboot, you can close out of the command prompt. Now it's time to access the card online and make sure the reload of the data file was successful. Before accessing it, though, it's important to clear your Java cache to ensure that you download the latest version of the Java applet. To do this, go into your computer's control panel. Click Java. Open the General tab. Go into Settings. And click Delete Files. Make sure you check all three file types on this list. After you've checked all three file types, click OK. Click OK again. Then click OK one final time. After you've cleared your Java cache, open up a web browser. Then go to the IP address of the SNMP web card and log in. After you log in, go into the Help section of PowerAlert and confirm that there is no error message in the driver file status field. If the status is normal, you'll know that the problem has been corrected. Thank you for your interest in TripLite products.